Wandering in the desert with a horse with no name. Hi guys, Golden Tails Geek here. Welcome back to more Golden Sun. In the last episode, we solved the puzzles of Venus Lighthouse, and I showed off a couple of RNG tricks to get the best non-cursed weapon and armor for Garrett and Ivan, respectively. And in this episode, we're here in the Sohala Desert because I mentioned in the last episode that there was a way you could return to Crossbone Isle from here, and you might be wondering how we do that. So I'm going to show off what to do. First off, let's just head over here. We're going to head off to the little area where we were earlier, where I got that Mars Genie, provided I don't get interrupted by enemies like that Magikarp. But anyway. And of course, as soon as I say anything, I get interrupted again by a couple Harridans and a roach. And when I say roach, I certainly don't mean marijuana. Oh my god, I can't believe I just said that. But anyway, now let's just use the reveal synergy to reveal this platform here, and we'll continue onward before I make even more inadvertent, less than family-friendly drug jokes. But anyway, there's no random encounters in this cave, so thank god for that, so no worries there. But if you keep going through here, you'll see this red tornado thing, not unlike that one, clear one that housed that storm lizard we had to fight in order to get through here earlier. So what you have to do is you enter the storm, but whatever you do, do not use douse on it. I mean, I will show off what happens when you do use douse on it, but still. But that'll happen later. And now, as you can see, if we zoom out, we're on Crossbone Isle! Also, interesting little glitch, if you go to your little status menu thing, the tornado will go from clear to solid and spin around like that, almost looking like the tornadoes in this one level of Donkey Kong Land. It's kind of funny. At least to me it is, but eh. Anyway, now that we're here on Crossbone Isle, and as you can see, I already opened the entrance like several parts ago, but I did that to kind of save myself some time later on, earlier on. But in fact, the part in which I showed off how to get to Crossbone Isle from the Caragol Sea actually went up yesterday as of this recording. So that should give you some idea of how far in advance I record these videos. But anyway, now I'm going to give Isaac one of Garrett's fire synergy. Or fire gin, rather, and assign the growth synergy, and I'm going to use the vines to climb up here and drop down, and you don't need to see me do that again, so I'm going to cut that out, so I'll be back in a few. Alright, we're back. Well, let's head in. Now, there are no random encounters here in Crossbone Isle, thankfully, but there are some really big, there can be some really tough boss fights if you're a bit underleveled, so, I mean, there's like 10 floors you have to go through, pretty much. Well, 9, but I'm counting the last floor, the last thing that shows up on the last part as a 10th floor, but whatever. Anyway, and each floor, if you head towards these doors, will have a boss fight of some description. They start out kind of easy, especially if you're at my level, like in the late 20s like this, but they get progressively more difficult as you go, and trust me when I tell you, some of them are really downright brutal. So you might want to really prepare yourself before coming in here, and I would actually suggest you kind of don't come in until you get into this either this level or at least have this all these djinn, because it's going to be a long haul, not going to lie. And also, some of the puzzles in this dungeon can be really mind-bending as well. Now with that said, let's head over here, and we'll do our first boss fight, which is a couple of Viragos and a Hobgoblin. The Viragos we've encountered before, so we can just take care of these like nobody's business, like we just did. So good job, Isaac and Ivan. And the Hobgoblins is not really much of a threat, even though he just used crystal powder there. He's pretty much just a bigger, more intimidating version of the kobold slash goblin enemies that we encountered a few parts ago, so that's no worries. So let's just keep on going here. And we'll just keep slashing at him, because he's pretty much a weakling if you play it, really. And we always get a lucky medal from that fight, so that's really nice. In fact, let's there sort that. Now, there's 5 chests in each of the rooms you go into here, so keep that in mind. And also in each of these one of these chests is always going to be a number of coins that's a multiple of 111. So since this is the first floor, we'll be getting 111 coins, but on subsequent floors it'll be like 222, 333, etc. So that's something to just keep in mind for now. Anyway, and also some of these items are not really as useful as you think as useful really. I love that noise when you open up the door. I like that. I don't know why. Something about sound design. I love that. I don't know. Maybe I'm just weird. Let's see. Now I gotta remember. I think it's this way I gotta go for the next chest. Or maybe I'm way off. Oh, no, I'm not way off. Cool. Awesome. And we got a hard nut. Awesome. So far so good. No worries there. Of course, I gotta exit the room and come back. I don't know if I expect to go to the second floor, but that's fine. Anyway, there we go. Yeah, the puzzles also start out kind of simple and straightforward, really, but as you progress, you'll realize that some of them, like I said, can be a total mind bend, really, if you're not prepared, so... Okay, now let's just scooch this pillar over like that. Awesome. And then we'll just keep on bouncing over here, I think. Yeah, okay. So now we're on to something here. Awesome. So far so good. Easy does it. Slow and steady wins the race, as they say. And then we'll scooch it back at the pillar over there. And now we've made it past the first floor already. Aren't you proud of me, folks? Aren't you proud? Anyway, let's just push this boulder over like so, and we'll have a handy way to exit, should we require it. Now, you open up this chest, and it's another mimic. So, no worries. I'm just gonna attack it and because this mimic, while it's probably the strongest one in the game, it's pretty much weak because of the fact that I'm so high level at this point, but... In fact, I think it's the last mimic in the game, if memory serves me correctly, so I almost feel sorry for it, really. Yeah, let's do a fever. Titan Blade! Oh, well, that was easy. And Mia gained a level from that. Awesome. And we got a potion, so that's nice. Alright, let's just organize our items. And let's continue on. Here we are, the second floor. And now we've got a couple of grizzlies and a succubus, but these guys can be pretty easy if you know what you're doing. Hopefully I know what I'm doing, otherwise I'm pretty gonna be pretty much screwed. Yeah, succubus is good. The succubus has an annoying tendency to do that. And the grizzlies have a tendency to kind of raise their attack power by erupting into a furious rage like those trolls in Venus Lighthouse, but still. Like, shouldn't be too difficult. I hope, anyway. Oh, pardon me. A little residual from lunch, I suppose. But anyway, let's try to attack the succubus now that we've kind of gotten the we're almost on the verge of getting the grizzlies done and dusted here. Okay, I guess not. And yeah, the succubus has a tendency to do that glowering thing, which is really bothersome, but oh well. Good job, Ivan. Now let's finish off this grizzly, and we'll be ready to go. And you'll always get a potion from that fight, so... Anyway, let's open up this chest. Let's see. An elixir. Meh. 222 coins. Not too shabby. And let's see. Ooh, some lucky pepper. Very nice. That'll come in handy later. Anyway, let's just saunter up here. Push this thing up like so. Perfect. Push this up. Okay, good, good, good. Push this over, like that. Push this up, like this. And let's open up this chest and see what we got here. Ah yes, the mystery blade. That, if you had come here earlier when you were after you had sailed the Karagol Sea, that weapon would actually be pretty strong for this for that point in the game. But I don't know. I just like to do Crossbone Isle all at once. And it has an unleash called Life Nourish, which actually functions almost like the Sap Genie in that once you attack an enemy, it saps their HP and allows it to you to replenish your health, which is not too bad, but I don't know, it's kind of weak now that I've pretty much dressed to the nines with the best equipment. But anyway, let's do the next boss fight here. And it's Fiendish Ghouls and a Lich. The Fiendish Ghouls definitely live up to their name because they're like their previous counterparts where they can chomp on you and replenish their HP, so you might want to take them down quick. And liches also have a tendency to bind your synergy, so that's really annoying as well. Oh, hello, Cannibal Fang. Oh, it didn't work on Isaac. Ah, nice try, guy, but not nice enough. Anyway, let's take care of these fiendish ghouls here. Okay, that's one down. That's two. Ah, yes, and liches can use Enfeeble, which lowers your elemental resistances, which is kind of bothersome, but if you can really take them down quick, you don't have to worry about that. I think they also have a haunting attack, which is kind of bothersome, like they're kind of the ghostly counterparts that... Yeah, I was right then. Awesome. And thankfully, it had no effect on Isaac nor Garrett, so that's thankful. Awesome. Ooh, and I even gained a level from that fight. Awesome. Very good. Okay, we got a Psy Crystal. Oh, yes, I remember this. Okay, I have the catch synergy equipped here. You have to use the catch synergy to get these keys here because... Yeah. So, that's something to keep in mind. This is something to keep in mind, so... Oh, hang on a sec. Can I get that key? Oh, nope, I can't. Okay. Oh, I know what to do now. I know what to do now. Okay. Oh, hold up. There we go. Okay, that's two blue keys. You only get these keys in this dungeon, by the way. Keep that in mind. But, This is a tricky puzzle, not gonna lie. I gotta remember how to do this because I haven't played in so long, this dungeon in so long. Ugh. Has it really been that long since my practice run? Yes, folks, it really has. I actually thought about doing a little practice thing before I headed out. I headed through here, but oh well. Didn't happen. Okay, that's three blue keys, I believe. Alright, cool. So far, so good. Now I gotta find a way to get that other blue key and we'll be ready as rain here. Oh, son of a gun. I know what I'm doing wrong here. Okay, cool. Excellent. Alright. Now, let's just bounce over here. Boing, 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 boing. And then, we're gonna head over here real quick, use the reveal synergy, and we can use catch, and we'll get the red key. So that's really nice. Alright. And now we can just open up these doors here. Let's see what you got. Let's see. Smoke bomb? Nah. Cookie. Okay, good. That's a good one. I like that. A fairy ring. I forget what that does. Fairy ring here. Oh, it basically replenishes any status ailments in battle, like an elixir. And 333 coins. Very nice. And we also have the red key, so we can head through here and continue on to the next floor. And let's just push this boulder down. However, I think we've made good time. We've done three floors. So, yeah, I think we did good. So, next time on Let's Play Golden Sun, we'll continue on through Crossbone Isle. And we'll get to see if we can get more treasure and fight more bosses. Until then, this has been Golden Tales Geek. Thank you guys so much for watching this, and keep on gaming. Bye, everyone!